Hello and welcome to Columbus State Library's tutorial on using CINAHL. CINAHL is a database of nursing and allied health literature. To access CINAHL, navigate to the database's AZ page on the library website and click on the letter C, and then scroll down to CINAHL. If you're off campus, at this point you will be prompted to log in with your username and password. At this point, you're able to enter your search term and click search to do a basic search, but by scrolling down, you'll be able to use a variety of settings and options to tailor your search. We will look at some of the most commonly used tools on this page. First, enter your search term. This should be a keyword or keywords based on your topic, thesis, or PICO question. I'm going to start with something simple like asthma treatment. You can use the drop-down boxes to add more keywords to your search with and, or not. To select the publication date range for your search, type the desired date range into one of the search bars and then click on the drop-down box to the right of that search bar and select the option publication date, DT. Scroll down and you'll see a list of limiters you can use to specify the kind of search results you want to see. You can experiment with these limiters, but remember that the more you select, the narrower your search will be and the fewer results you'll get. One important item on this list is EBSCO full text only. By clicking this checkbox, your search results will be limited to only articles that have full text access. This way you'll always be able to read the entire article immediately. Below the list of limiters, you'll see a drop-down box labeled publication type. Here, you can select the types of articles and reports that you want to see in your results. If you're looking for evidence-based articles, select the following: case study, clinical trial, meta-analysis, meta-synthesis, practice guidelines, research, review, standards, systematic review, and randomized controlled trial. The age and sex limiters will specify the desired age and sex of the study participants. The journal subset limiter will limit the type of journals searched. So if your assignment requires you to use an article from a nursing journal, you can select nursing under journal subset. The geographic subset limiter will limit the search to studies published in a specific country, whereas the location of practice limiter will limit where the research took place. You can also limit the desired number of pages and the language. Now that you've selected your search options, click the blue search button at the bottom right corner of the page, and you will see your search results. You can see here that there are about 62 results for this particular search. At this point, you can feel free to edit your search term in the search bar at the top, and your search settings should remain. You can also edit how many search results appear per page and how the search results are sorted. Select an article and click the title to see additional information about the article. You'll see publication information like the names of the article's authors and the journal or magazine in which the article was published. Be sure to scroll down to see the abstract, which is a brief summary of the article's main points. Reading the abstract is a very important part of the research process. It allows you to get an idea of the article's content before you spend time reading the article itself. After reading the abstract, you can access the text of the article by scrolling up and clicking on the drop-down menu labeled Access Options. Click PDF if you want to see the article in PDF form, and online full text if you want to view the article on the web page. The article will appear in the same way it would in the print version of the publication, and you can see that all tables, charts, graphs, and images are included. To get the article's citation from the article's information page, which is the same page that shows the abstract, click the quotation mark icon to the upper right of the article's title. This will open a window with a drop-down menu of citation formats. Select the format you're using for your paper, like APA, and a citation for the article will be generated. You can copy and paste this citation onto your References or Works Cited page. Remember that these citations are automatically generated, so it's always recommended to double-check this citation to make sure the format is correct. There are a few ways to save an article to access later. One way is to click the Download button. You will have the option of downloading a PDF or the online full text version. You can also download the article by clicking on the download icon that looks like a downward arrow at the upper right-hand corner of the page above the article's title near the citation icon. If you want to save a link to this page to read or download the article later, click the share icon, which looks like a right-pointing arrow, then click create link. Copy this link and save it, and it will always link you back to this page. It's important to note that clicking the save icon, which looks like a bookmark or ribbon, will only save the article until you close your browser tab, unless you create a My EBSCO account, which you can do by clicking My EBSCO in the upper right corner of the page.